So it's really important for you to understand why birthing better families developed these skills. We wanted skills that worked. And at that time in the early 1970s, there was only a 4.5% cesarean rate. So the skills we were developing were for those people who were going to labor and have a vaginal birth. And pain was definitely the elephant in the room. Women wanted to be in control of pain, and they couldn't control pain. So we started to use other words: cope, manage, deal with, handle, work through, stay on top of, feeling control. So in this lesson, you're going to get an MP3 about pain, and you're going to get a handout on the hows and whys of pain, and another handout on the skills for working with pain. There's also another MP3 that is an audio of labor and how women use good breathing skills and how men or others can hear how women are coping. If women are coping fine, they will sound and look like they're coping fine. They may hate every moment, but if a woman looks and sounds like she's coping well, she is using skills to cope well. It's not instinct. She's choosing behaviors. You need to learn them. Then we found very early on, this is what women would say. At first, the contractions were light. They weren't very painful, and I didn't have any trouble coping. Then as time passed, the contractions got more intense. It was really a struggle to cope with it, but I managed. And then the labor contractions got really, really intense. They were so painful, and I lost it. I was overwhelmed. I felt out of control. What we learned as mothers and fathers was we were looking at a contraction as a whole unit. And in fact, a contraction had five phases. It started, pain increased, the pain peaked, the pain went away, and then there was space in between. In this handout, you're going to learn all the skills around using your skills in those five phases. This has made an incredible, remarkable change in how people use skills throughout their births. And these skills, of course, are just as valid for women who have non-laboring cesareans, or even if you're feeling anxious, or if you have postpartum discomforts, or discomforts breastfeeding, or any discomforts after a birth.